Hey guys, welcome to channel DevKage. In this video, we are going to see how to create our own custom clipper and use it to clip other widgets. Some of you might have already used clip rrect to make the corners of child widgets rounded. That widget is useful for simple cases, but when the clipping path that you want is complex, you can use a custom clipper. So let's get started. For this example, I'll use some images which I have already added in a folder called assets. And I've also added this folder under the assets section in PubSpec YAML. So first, I'll create a grid view using gridview.builder to display all the images from assets folder. For the delegate, I'll use sliver grid delegate with fixed cross access count. And I'll set the cross access count as 2. As I have added only 18 images in assets, I'll set the item count to 18. Next, item builder will be a function which takes a build context and an index. From this builder, I'll return a grid tile. Child property of this grid tile will be an image widget which will display an image from the assets folder. Here, I'll do some string interpolation to pick the correct image. And to make sure that each image covers all the available space, let's set the fit property to boxfit.cover. And once I save this, you can see that now we have a nice grid of images. So now let's start clipping. For this, I'll first wrap the image widget in a clip path. Clip path has a property called clipper, and this is where we can specify our custom clipper. So let's create a new file for the clipper. I'll name this file as image_clipper.dart. Inside this file, I'll create a new class called image clipper, which will extend from custom clipper of type path. Custom clipper is an abstract class and forces us to implement two methods, getClip and shouldReClip. GetClip is the method where we create and return our own custom clip path. ShouldReClip is called by the Flutter framework to decide if reclipping is needed or not. For now, I'll just return true here. But ideally, we should check the state of old clipper to decide if reclipping is really needed. From the getClip method, I'll just return a default path object for now. Now let's go to the main.dart file and set this image clipper as the clipper for clip path. And as soon as I save this, you can see that everything disappears. This is because right now the path that we returned from getClip is empty. So let's see how to create a path. First, I'll create an object of path and save it in a variable called path. This path will be returned from this method. Now, if you check the path class, you'll find many methods to create paths. You can create straight lines, arcs, quadratic curves, and cubic curves. But for this video, we'll be only using lines. So to create a line, I'll use path.lineTo method. This method needs the x and y coordinate of the endpoints of the line. The last point in this path is automatically used as the start point. Initially, this will be same as the top left corner. And notice that we also get an object of size as input to this getClip method. This is the size within which this clip will be applied. So I'll use this size to specify coordinates for lineTo method. First, I'll create a line from initial point to size.width, 0. Then next, I'll create another line from size.width, 0 to size.width, size.height. And now if I save this, you can see that a triangular clip has been applied for each image. This is because we have wrapped each image inside clip path. And for each image, the initial start point will be the top left corner of that image. So when we call path.lineTo size.width, 0, it creates a horizontal line. And when we call path.lineTo size.width, size.height, it creates a vertical line from previous point. And since we didn't close the path, it gets automatically closed by connecting last endpoint and the initial start point. So just to drive this concept home, I'll add one more line which will end at size.width by 2, size.height. As you can see, now the path went till half the width horizontally and then got automatically closed. If I make this 0 instead of width by 2, we'll get the whole image. Now when your path just contains straight lines, you can create a list of offset of these points and then use the path.addPolygon. Just remember that if you use this method, you'll also have to specify the start point. which in this case is 0,0. So this is how custom clippers work in general. You just have to define your clipping path manually. Now, finding out the exact endpoints for generating a specific clip shape is time consuming. So to make our lives easier, I'll head over to the clip path generator on cssportal.com. Here, you'll find clip paths for multiple shapes. The only problem is that the output values are specifically designed to work in CSS. But we can easily convert these values to work with our custom clipper. For example, let's use this parallelogram. I'll copy this polygon string and paste it as comment for our reference. So here, you can see that we have 4 comma separated coordinates, one for each corner. And for each point, the percentage is with respect to size.width or size.height depending on the x or y coordinate. So let's modify our offsets according to these values. And now if I save this, we indeed get a parallelogram shape. So all this is great, but this method still requires us to carefully add all the offsets, and chances of making a mistake is high. So let's make this even better. Let's add some code which will automatically pass the string and return a list of points. For this, I'll create a new method in this class called extractPoints. Its return type will be a list of offsets, and it will need two parameters. First will be a string to parse, and second will be size. So in getClip, we can call this extractPoints. Let's convert this comment into a final string called clipPath. So now, extractPoints will take this clipPath and size as input, and it will return a list of points which can be directly passed onto addPolygon. Now let's start implementing extractPoints. First, I'll create a final variable called points, which will be empty list of offsets with growable as true. This is the main list which will be returned from this method. Next, let's replace all the percentage signs from the string with an empty string. For this, I'll use the replaceAll method on clipPath. ReplaceAll returns a new string which I'll store in a temp string variable. Next, I'll again call replaceAll on this temp variable, but this time I want to remove the blank space after each comma. So I'll replace each comma followed by a space with just a comma. This will effectively remove the empty space, and I'll store the returned string again in the same temp string. Now I'll split this temp string at comma. This will give us a list of strings where each string represents the x and y coordinate of a point separated by an empty space. So I'll loop over this list of point strings, and I'll split each point string at empty space. This will again give us a list of strings. And if everything goes as per the plan, this list should have only two elements. First being the x coordinate, and second will be y coordinate. So here, if the length of this list is 2, I'll add a new point in the points list. And to get the x and y coordinate of this point, I'll use first and second element of quad respectively. And since these elements are strings, I'll use double.parse to convert them into a double. This completes the definition for extractPoints. If I save this, everything should remain as it was before implementing extractPoints. Now just to check if this is working fine, I'll copy string for another shape from CSS portal and will set it as the new clip path. And as you can see, the shape changed correctly. And that was it for this video. Using this small piece of code, you can easily generate custom clip paths directly from CSS strings, as long as you make sure they are polygons. I'll see if I can come up with something similar for other curve types too. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, hit that like button, maybe consider subscribing for more such content, and I'll hope to see you in the next one.